स्कूल में दाखिल हुए, कौन? कृष्ण महापुरुष स्वरूप, और वहां पर उन्होंने शिक्षा लाभ की। विशाखा जी से जरा पिता जी के अंदर में कौन से भाव है, कैसे इसको आप अभिनय कर सकते हैं, कैसे आस्वादन कर सकते हैं, और इसके बाद में शिवपुरी में आते हैं। गदाधर जी कौन है, इनको राधा जी का प्रकाश किया, राधा जी ये वहां पर गंभीराने की भावों का आस्वादन करे, कैसे 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 इनके जो भाव हुए जो राधिका जी के थे। किंतु श्रीमद् भागवत में राधा जी के अष्ट सात्विक विकार जो कि महा उज्ज्वल है उनका वर्णन नहीं आया, महाप्रभु के लीला चरित्र में देखा जाता है। इसी से कल्पना कीजिए राधा जी के भाव कैसे, इसलिए ये राधा जी के उन्नत उज्ज्वल भाव की स्त्री श्री माने शोभा वो भाव नहीं दिया जा सकता, उसकी स्त्री को देने के लिए। कैसे, जैसे एक लता है, लता में यदि पत्ते ना हो, हरियाली ना हो और उसमें फूल और फल ना हो तो लता का माधुर्य नहीं। लता तो ये श्रीमती राधिका जी स्वयं है, ये पत्ते क्या है, इनकी सखियां हैं, और इसमें फल फूल जो हैं वो भी सखियां एक तरह की, और मंजरी होती है, मंजरी से लता की शोभा होती है, जहां हवा के झोंके आए मंजरी उधर उधर जाएगी, पत्ते जुड़ेंगे, तो ये लता का ये लता की ये शोभा है। तो श्रीमती राधिका जी की मंजरियां जो है उनकी दासियां हैं, जो उनकी राधिका जी के एक एक भाव है, और इस रूप में कृष्ण की सभी मिलकर के ये सेवा करती हैं, सभी माने राधिका की एक मूल है और उनकी सखियां जो है उनसे अलग नहीं, उन्हीं के एक एक भाव है, वो लता और पुष्प है, मंजरी नहीं रहने से उसकी शोभा नहीं। इसलिए इस सखी के भाव को देने के लिए पार्थिव भाव में ये चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी अभी रस आस्वादन किया, जगत को दिया। इसलिए चैतन्य महाप्रभु आप सब लोगों के ऊपर में कृपा करें, जो हम राधा जी के दासी को भाव को यदि किसी समय अनुभव करते जाते और उनको इसी रूप में हम साधना कर, आप जानते हैं वेद की ऋचाएं भी इस रूप से सेवा, हमारे वेद की ऋचाएं जनकपुर की महिलाएं हमारे दंडकारण्य के 60,000 ऋषि लोग इस भाव को पाने के लिए 60,000 वर्ष की तपस्या की, आराधना की राधा जी की। कृष्ण ने स्वयं ब्रह्मा जी को गोपाल मंत्र और ये काम गायत्री अपने आप को दिया, इसलिए ब्रह्मा जी हमारे इस संप्रदाय के आदि गुरु हैं, क्योंकि कृष्ण ने स्वयं बंसी के द्वारा उनको ये सब दिया। इसलिए मैं आप लोगों से यही निवेदन करता हूँ कि राधा जी के चरणों में आप लोग की मति हो, राधा जी से प्रार्थना करता हूँ, और मैं समझता हूँ कि आज हम कृतार्थ हो गए कि आप सभी लोग मिलकर के एक ऐसा वातावरण बनाया जिससे हमारी यात्रा अवश्य सफल होगी, और आप
अभिनंदन श्रृंखला में श्री रमेश चंद जी बेरीवाल, श्री रमेश चंद जी बेरीवाल बहन तुलसीबाई
श्री राधे, जय जय श्री राधे। श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे
Thank you. Just like the gopis, those who's anurag is not so high, their family members, they check them from going to ras, and what happens? Their anurag increases. So in the same way, when we are being checked from coming into sadhu sangha and bhajan, then
our... Sometimes I die for Maharaj.
Yes.
And I feel that he is going to leave the body any time, and I will never see him again. Every time I see him, Prabhu, every time I see him and I tell him this thing, this is the last time I am seeing you. Probably I will never see you. He tells me, no, I will never leave you. You will always be with me. I will be always with you. That separation, I cannot stay without him. That kind of feeling is there for a long time. That Maharaj. Okay. So this I have understood. So once you transcend to the
From here to Bauma Vrindavan, from Bauma Vrindavan to Golok. Yeah, first Swarup Siddhi in this life, then Vastu Siddhi in Bauma Vrindavan, then one becomes, afterwards, Parikara. If the Anurag is mature, then you can become Parikara.
If you're not mature, then you go to another leela happening in another universe,
another time. Yes.
That can continue.
And
what
how,
are the qualifications?
How does it become mature? How does a premi become mature?
Exactly. That's why I want to ask.
Sadhu sangha, sarva shastikai. Just as in this life we progress by sadhu sangha, in that life the only way the gopis can mature is by association with the Nitya Siddhanta of your gopis.
But then they are born there. Why they are not associating?
Because then they associate with the sadhan siddha, other sadhan siddha. Or they may associate with the Sakya Dasya Vatsayara.
They still have a choice.
We have choice all the time. That choice is never taken away from us.
So while doing sadhana in this life, we should think that
very deep attachment to Rupa Manjari and Rati Manjari.
Absolutely.
So we can be with them. Or naturally,
absolutely,
we will be attached to them. And to our Gurudev. We should, because Gurudev, he has given everything. Guru Gayatri. Yoga Mantra Sa Guru Sakshad.
Guru, I have given you the seed, please, mantra.
In our Guru Gayatri, the Sroop of our Guru is there. If we chant this mantra according to the process,
we can realize
Panchanga Diksha, then the Swarupa Gurudev comes in the heart of the sadhak. You know Panchanga Diksha? In Diksha there are five things. First, Mantra Artha Chintan. Nyas.
First is the?
Mantra Artha Chintan.
Mantra?
Mantra Artha
Chintan.
Chintan. Mantra Artha Chintan.
Mantra
Artha means the meaning of the words of the mantra. Chintan is meditating on that.
Yes.
So in that there should be some Vanda Gyan. This means you should know who is the deity of the mantra. Each mantra has an Adhishtati Devata. So who is the Adhishtati Devata and what is my Vanda with the Adhishtati Devata? Remembering this and mantra Artha Chintan, the meaning of each word, this is the first stage. After this, Nyas. Nyas means to make a vow under the order of Guru to chant the mantra a fixed number of times. One mantra has enough power to reveal everything. But because our mind is unsteady, then we chant. Our Gurudev tells us we should do 10 times, each time we chant Agati, each mantra 10 times. Why? Because perhaps out of 10 times, one time our mind may be steady and the mantra may come in our hearts. If we only chant one time every day, then it will take a long time. And for those who are very serious, they should chant the Gopal Mantra 108 times in addition.
Puri Maharaj ki pas mala for
Raghav! Raghav!
108
times
you can chant on
the
last.
Yes,
Gopal
Mantra.
All 9 of them.
No, only Gopal Mantra.
Last one.
No, last but one. Last one is called Kam Gayatri.
Kam Gayatri.
Let me ask a question
to you.
This prominent mantra for establishing. Yes, this is the main mantra for establishing our Sambandha with Radha Krishna and manifest our own.
There is a description on this. Maharaj told me earlier also, day before yesterday, when I was forming the second. It was a desire, he was not ready for a long time. But last time when I went to Radha Krishna, he said, okay, Radha Ashtami time. He said, okay, next time when we meet.
So here you just took mantra from Gurudev.
I took it again. I have taken Gopal mantra from my Guru Maharaj.
Yes, yes.
In 1986 at Mayapur. Lord Chaitanya Swami is very auspicious thing. So, 2nd of March, I remember now. It is an important day in my life because I was born. Harinam is very important, but that just prepares you for it. But in the course of the time, I lost concentration and thinking. So I wanted to get reinitiated.
Because you cannot get mantra siddhi without having shiksha in this mantra. How to obtain mantra siddhi? It's called Panchanga Diksha.
So I spent a lot of time with my Guru Maharaj and Arunandavan, but then going at home, married life, that created a lot of. So I wanted to.
He gave some explanation about
those
Gopal mantra.
Yeah, he explained to me.
No.
For
example, that.
He gave some explanation, not much at the time.
Panchanga Diksha, this process, we must know this. I know many gurus They don't give the disciple.
They just give the printed. Just do it.
Even some they're giving mantra because they don't know themselves the what is Panchanga Diksha and all of these things.
Then but the description is written somewhere?
Panchanga Diksha. Okay. It is given by
including all the meaning, deep meaning, bija meaning which Maharaj told me day before yesterday.
That is here and there in different books. But Panchanga Diksha, what is the actual process for getting mantra siddhi, is given by Sanatana Goswami Pari in his tika, his own tika on Brit Bhagavatam. When the Brahmin they went to Pragjyotishpur and had a dream.
The English version is having also?
No, there's no translation of the tika. There's no translation in English of the tika, only the
Bengali
one. Bengali.
I don't know Bengali. I must
learn. I'm going to be in very soon.
I'm learning
this translation.
Gopi Paranayan.
Sanatana Goswami, this I can read, right? You want me to see that, right?
When the Brahmin went to Pragjyotishpur and he received mantra in a dream from Devi. In the commentary here, Sanatana Goswami Pada has written about Panchanga Diksha.
Okay. So you are, we are on the second stage.
From Devi.
Huh?
What do you say? Received from Devi.
Devi.
So this is on? Or you are recording him?
Thank you, bro. I know.
Okay. So we are on the second stage in Panchanga Diksha.
Nyasa is the vow to repeat this very carefully. Because the mind is here and there,
mm-hmm.
Perhaps one mantra will come in. After this, there are three stages, Prapati, Sharanagati and Atmanivedha. So, Prapati means the sadhak is remembering the date of the mantra. And he's thinking, you are all powerful, you have all potency, all strength, all knowledge, and you have all mercy and all sweetness, everything. So, I'm taking complete shelter of you, giving up all other shelters. I'm taking complete shelter of you forever. This is called Prapati.
Mm-hmm.
Then after this, Sharanagati. This has six angas. You know, Anukuyena Kaka Patakuya Sabhajanam. Rakshishati ti vishvasu gopitai varanamtika atmanikshepana karpanye sadvidha shanagati six angas of shanagati and then last atmanivedha. This atmanivedha, if one completes the four angas then he can understand atma and then give this atma. Without knowing the atma you cannot do atmanivedha. So first in our atmanivedha in the immature stage is our body, mind and words. This is all we know. Whatever we have, we give this. But when the Sarupa of the Atma comes out, that time then it's the real Atma in the Veda. At that time, then the one can directly serve Krishna, his lotus feet directly. That is, and then Diksha is complete. Diksha is not one day. Diksha is a course.
Absolutely.
So, Mahaprabhu told Sanatana Goswami, Diksha Kali, Vakra Kari, Atma Samarpan, Sai Kali, Krishna Kari, Tari Atma Sam, Sai Kali Kari, Tari Chidanandamai, Haprakrita Deya Dhara, Charna Bhajai. At the time of Diksha, it is Atma Nivedan. That time Krishna accepts him and he serves directly Krishna's lotus feet in Siddha Deha.
Okay.
This is Diksha.
So that happens much later.
Yes. When we receive mantra, this means that we have been accepted into the school of Diksha.
Right.
When you go to university, on the first day you enroll. You enroll. This is not graduation.
Right.
You have years of study and
Absolutely.
Then you will have an examination, then you have
that
graduated.
That I always feel, I have not graduated myself.
So Diksha is the process. Divyam Jnanam Yato Dadyat Karyat Papa Sasangshayam Tasmat Dikshati Kovida. This verse.
What do you make Narayan Maharaj, I'm asking you.
Yeah.
You have been with him for how many years?
I am only with him since almost 4 years. I am with him. And before that, I was with Srila Gaura Govinda Maharaj.
Okay.
You are
his disciple?
No, you see, I took Diksha from Harikeswami.
Okay.
I came to ISKCON when I was 17 years old,
okay.
1987.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So
you came later than me, and you are more elevated.
That time I'm 17 years old. I had just left school.
Where? Which place?
I was born in England. I joined at Bhaktivedanta Manan, you know?
Okay.
So I took initiation.
Details
area. Yes, I took initiation from Hari Keswami, but after a few years I became frustrated. I felt that he was not speaking according to Siddhanta. Now the whole world has seen Hari is falling down.
In the school there, college, there is a school also, right?
Yes, yes, there's a Gurukul, but for small children. Not I was 17 when I came in. So then I left him and I took shelter of Bhogavana Maharaj. And I asked him for Diksha. He's Mahabhagavat, great Vaishnava. So I took shelter of him and asked him for Diksha, but he said, I cannot give you because they were trying to throw him out of ISKCON. And I was a quite prominent disciple of Hari Keswami. So when I left him and came to Gurukul Maharaj, it was a big disturbance in ISKCON in Europe. So he said, if I give you Diksha, they will throw me out of ISKCON. And then how will I serve my Prabhupada? I have made this temple in Bhubaneswar and everything. So he couldn't. So he was like my Shiksha Guru. Then when he left...
You stayed for how many years?
I was with him for 3 years.
So you learned all the Shastra with him there?
Yes, in Bhubaneswar. I was following him in Europe for some years. Uh-huh. And then he asked me to come...
He's very learned. I've seen his books.
Yes, yes. Then he asked me to come and live with him in Bhubaneswar. So then I moved to Bhubaneswar. And then after the beginning of 1996, then he left this world. And then shortly after that...
You spent 12 years continuously in ISKCON.
So yes.
That makes difference.
Yes. Then
I spent from 80s, you know, 5 years, then when
I am Brahmachari, red cloth Brahmachari, and only just in the mat all the time.
Don't take white.
In
ever.
Company of my
don't
friend
take white
in the Bhakata
Prabhu. Don't take white. I never wore saffron because in the beginning I knew that if I have to marry as an Indian, I will never use saffron. Means in India is like sadhu.
Yes.
Nobody knows Brahmachari means then you can take grahastha.
Yes,
if
impossible.
I see you in this and then you see you with a woman, my respect for you is gone,
yes.
Forever. As an Indian, I'm just saying.
In Gaudiya Math, in ISKCON red, you can wear red afterwards you put on white.
Right.
But in Gaudiya Math, if you put on red cloth, it is sannyas.
Correct.
The junior sannyas and senior sannyas.
Absolutely.
Like this. This is the riti in India. Yes. Yeah. So, then when Srila Guru Gobind Maharaj left this world, then by his inspiration, in my heart, in a dream, he brought Srila Narayana Maharaj to me in a dream.
Mm-hmm.
So then I left Orissa and came to Mathura.
4 years ago?
And took shelter of... yes.
So
I,
you were re-initiated with my Maharaj?
Only not re-initiated, real initiation. Not re-initiation, real initiation.
Real.
Because I never had any initiation from Guru Govinda Maharaj. He accepted me as Shiksha disciple. That would have been real initiation, but he did not give me
so
Diksha.
So you took Harinam only before?
No, I took Harinama Diksha from Hari Keswami, but I rejected him. And I stopped chanting mantra also, because I know this mantra.
Gayatri mantra.
Yes, I know this mantra has no power. And what is the proof? Now we see, that 5 years after I left him, more than that, then he fell down. Hmm? Unless mantra is coming from a Sadguru, then this mantra is not powerful. Hmm? Anyone can give mantra, but what is this mantra? It is like if you have a gun. Mm? With blank cartridges.
Nope.
It will go bang, but you cannot shoot anything.
Yeah.
In the same way, anyone can speak the mantra. They make the same sound, but does it have the power to do anything? This is the question. So only those who have mantra siddhi, they themselves have realized mantra. They can give mantra.
On the top of it.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes. So then I received.
He's giving to a lot of people.
Harinama Diksha together on the same day. Because I was already devotee for many years, so he gave me Nama Diksha same day. And then since that time, Gurudev, he always keeps me with him going everywhere in the world. Only place I never came with him was Bombay, because he comes here for a few days on his way somewhere else. So what he does is he usually sends me directly to that place to prepare when he will come. He comes to Bombay on the way to anywhere other place, so he usually sends me directly there. So that's why I never came here.
Maybe whenever I'm there, you were traveling somewhere.
I'm in my room, locked away and writing. Usually wherever Gurudev is, I am also there. I usually don't go traveling without Gurudev. But this year he sent me for 1 month preaching, just 1 month, to Australia and Singapore and Malaysia. He sent me, and yeah, this was it. But otherwise I stay with Gurudev all the time.
4 years he has made you a good devotee.
What do you say?
Is there any difference? This is the coming directly from the lips of Mahaprabhu. It is not different from us.
Why is he explaining?
I am talking about the origin of Upadeshamrita.
Origin of Rupa.
Rupa Goswami is Upadeshamrita. What is the origin? It came from Mahaprabhu.
Yeah, came from
when he was just coming out from Bhav in the mood of Radhika, and he collapsed at Chatak Parvat thinking it was Giraj Govardhan. Banadeki Pramahoy Ehi Govardhan. Shaira Deki Manahoy Ehi Govardhan.
Where did you learn Bangla? With Gaurav Maharaj?
Only listening.
But
he
never went to school to learn.
Why? Why he knows more now Hindi.
Only hearing the Gogol Maharaj.
But you didn't learn from the alphabet.
So. I know how to read the Bangla.
So you learn from books. You know any good books? I want to learn more. Sanskrit I know, but I want to. Yeah.
One course. One.
No, yeah,
now what you say about the Mahaprabhu
okay.
And then.
Next question. Question.
Wait, let's finish.
Let me
just 2 minutes.
Okay, sure.
What?
You didn't finish.
Finished,
so
yeah.
I finished.
Now, this verse, 45th verse. Now, here's a very interesting thing, you know. Since Srimati Radharani is giving earth to Suryadeva, this disturbs me because of my ignorance. How Suryadeva, what he has to do in the Golok Vrindavan Dham? Is described in Bhagavad Gita as eye of Krishna, and in Srimad Bhagavatam as effulgence coming out of the Krishna's body. Who is this Surya? You know what I mean? My question, you got it?
You know.
It disturbed me quite.
Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami part. In his Govinda Lilamrita Granth, he has written one verse there. Gauravinda Kanti Nindi Chitta Pata Shatika Krishna Mata Brinda Keli Kula Pushpa Patika Krishna Nitya Sangamata Padma Bandhu Radhika Mayamatma Pada Padma Dasya Dastu Radhika. Sing it. Krishna Nitya Sangamata Padma Bandhu Radhika. Radhika's worshipping Padma Bandhu, that means the sun god. Why? Krishna Nitya Sangamata. Only to meet with Krishna.
Yeah.
If she stays in her home in Yavat Gaon, Krishna cannot come there. Jatilar is there, Kutilar is there, Abhimanyu.
Okay.
So many Guru Jana. So she's giving an excuse. She's telling her mother-in-law, I am going to worship Mitra. You know, Surya has another name, Mitra. You know? Another name for Surya is Mitra. She says, I'm going to worship Mitra. So she goes to Suryakund. And on the pretext of worshipping Surya.
That is okay, yeah.
But who is she going, what is she Krishna. Going there for? She's going to meet with Krishna. Like this. And she never told any lie. She didn't tell a lie to her mother-in-law. Why? Because Mitra means also a friend. You know? Aho Bhagyam, Nanda Gopa Brajokasam, Yan Mitram Paramanandam Purna Brahma Sanatanam. Brahmaji said, alas, alas, all the bridge vases like Nanda Baba Yashodamaya and all gopis and gopis, they're so lucky. They're so fortunate. Why? Yan Mitran, Krishna became their Mitra, became their bosom friend. So she said, I'm going to meet with Mitra. Her mother-in-law thinks the sun god, but actually she's going to meet with Krishna.
Smile.
This is just an excuse.
Yeah, but Prabhuji, where is the sun in Golok Dham? Is there any sun?
Yes.
Vivishvan is there? Vivishvan is in this world, right?
Try to understand. There,
who is this sun?
There,
you know my question I'm
going to ask? There.
Yes, yes.
Sun is Vivishvan right now in this.
This is in the material world.
Material
world. In the spiritual sky, everything is there. Everything. This dham is called, this level of knowledge is called pratyaksha. Pratyaksha means sense perception. Above this is the paroksha. This is called, aparoksha. This is called swarg, the realm of swarg. Above this is called paroksha. Paroksha gyan means brahma, mukti lok, liberation, sayujya mukti. And higher than that is Vaikuntha. This level is called Adhoksaj. Adhoksaj Gyan. Adaha. You know Adhoksaj? Adhoksaj. Adaha means below, pushing down. Aksha means eyes and Ja means which comes from the eyes. That that knowledge which minimizes the value of your sense perceptions is called adhoksaj. So adhoksaj tattva means Vaikuntha. And beyond Vaikuntha, that is the Krishna Loka, Loka Vrindavan planet, that is called Aprakrita. Aprakrita. So what is the meaning of Aprakrita? This is the question. This material world is called Prakrita. Prakrita is material. And Aprakrita means?
How are you?
In Sanskrit. Aprakrita. Prakrita means?
Which is not.
So actually this
not manifested.
This prefix a does not mean not. This a does not mean not. A prakrita does not mean not prakrita. In Sanskrit a means tulya, similar. So a prakrita actually means
actual.
No, prakrita vat. Prakrita vat. You know what? But means this is a this suffix means similar, tulya, similar. So aprakrita means similar to prakrita. So Vaikuntha Lok is not like this world. Oh, everyone has four arms and such opulence and mystical things are happening. But in Golok, it is just like this place. So it's called aprakrita. That means prakritavat, like prakrita. Aprakrita means prakritavat.
So reality is there.
Sometimes
everything is. Falsehood is here.
So,
there is the sun and the moon.
Sun, moon, everything, everything is there.
But they are not having any demigods. They are just
everything is by yoga maya.
Sometimes when you have bad knowledge, I don't want to say, but Sunday what is in this moment, somebody left, so, he went to Vaikuntha. But in Gaudiya Math, when sites are higher vice now, they don't say, going to Vaikuntha. He went to Aprakrit. Aprakrit.
Yeah.
Everybody said, Aprakrit.
Aprakrita.
In Golok Dham, everything is decorated by Lord Balrama's beauty.
Only 13 minutes left. Balrama is
manifesting the whole place.
Everything.
So this sun and moon are all coming from Balram, Lord Balram. Because on Krishna's
everything.
Body also, everything is from Balram. Correct?
Yes.
And on Radharani's body, everything is from Krishna, basically. In a way,
this is from different... in Tattva Vichar...
Sari, her... she wears the blue color. Maharaj is talking. I have a cassette from Maharaj.
When? Lunch time before.
Recently. Radhashtami time.
Yes. This is not
talking. You remember that?
Yes. This is not coming from Krishna. Gurudev is explaining one book. It is by Raghunath Das Goswami. It is called Premam Bhoja Marandakya Stotra Stavaraj. In this book, it's explaining the Swarupa of Radhika. But the lower dress. It's called it is Shama Patta.
Shama
Patta. This is Lajja. Her Lajja Bhava.
So Krishna is wrapping around her, no?
But, it's blackish.
Yes.
So this blackish, this reminds her of Krishna. But this, what is this Vastu? This is her Lajja. Lajja means her shyness. And her upper Vastra, this is the Arun Vastra, the
red.
Upper cloth. Reddish, like the rice, not full red. Like reddish pink. This is her anurag for Krishna. The kajal on her eyes is not made of kajal. Everything there is made of bhav only. Because she is Mahabhava Swarup. Her kajal is prema kutilya. So her love is very crooked. The crookedness of her prema is the kajal on her eyes. And on her body there is the... first, before she takes bath, her body is smeared with oil. What is that oil? That is Krishna's sneha, Krishna's affection.
Krishna's
sneha. Maharaj is talking exactly the
same. I know because I was there also.
You were there.
But I'm quoting.
I was not there, I missed it. So Premam Bhoja,
Premam Bhoja Marandakya Stotram.
Mm-hmm.
Gurudev is quoting from this. Raghunath Das Goswami is Premam Bhoja Marandakya Stotram.
What is the name of the book? Prema?
The book is on Stavavali. And in Stavavali?
Stavavali,
Stavavali.
I have heard about it.
Bamali.
In this,
it is called Prem Amboja.
Raghunath Das is also known as Das Goswami.
Raghunath Das Goswami.
He is also called as Das Goswami. Only
because there are so many Raghunaths. If you call him Raghunath Das Goswami, then no one will know who you're talking about. Because it's Raghunath Bhatta Goswami. The only one famous Das Goswami.
Das Goswami.
So which chapter?
Prema Bhoja.
Prema
Amboja.
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 Amboja. Amboja.
Amboja means lotus. Maranda. Maranda Akya.
Maranda.
Akya.
Word by word.
Akya.
Akya. Stotra. Stavaraj.
My full time study of this. So that's what Maharaj wanted me to do that. That's my next education in life. I have all the books but I don't get time to read. I'm a doctor, I'm running family. That's why you're saying that you have to choose.
Try to make an arrangement.
I'm trying
to have more sadhu sangha. This is better.
I do that quite a bit.
Sadhu sangha is better. I have no time to read. Only everything I've learned from hearing.
See, you have been there for 12 years full time as devotee.
And
with the good devotees. I have been full time for 5 years with good devotees. The rest is in between, I'm coming and going. Say another 2 years, 7 years. In that way, 5 years you are ahead. In 5 years, probably if I do the same, continue and increase it.
Mm-hmm.
Unless I increase very fast.
Mm-hmm.
So, that is required.
When I say sadhu sangha.
Yes, good sadhu sangha.
I'm saying sadhu. You know sadhu?
Yeah.
That means high level sadhu, realized.
That's what we were discussing.
This kind of sadhu sangha is rare. Try to.
Vasudevam Sarvamiti, some Mahatma Sudhu. I'm talking about that Mahatma. I consider Maharaj as that Vasudevam Sarvamiti.
Even this type of Mahatma, this is rare, but
no,
the type of sadhu I'm speaking of is more rare than this. Because this is someone who is Sharanagat.
Yes.
But Sharanagati is not so high.
No, of course. That verse can also be used for Krishna as Vasudev, ordinary Vasudev. Krishna can also be known as Vasudev, a beloved of Radharani, whom Radha is. And that if you love Krishna most, you will love Radha more than Krishna. So naturally that will come
yes.
step by step, right? So this Surya is there, but manifestation of Lord Balaram, just for the beautifying of Goloka. So Radharani is.
Natat Vasayate Suryo.
But she is really offering water.
Nasa Sankapa Vakaha.
You hear this verse?
Mm-hmm.
It disturbs me, you know?
No, huh? Radhika is worshipping Surya, but only this is for to attain Krishna. Only. This is a pretext.
But Surya is not Krishna.
There. There, no one knows. There, everyone is in ignorance.
Okay.
Hmm?
Nobody
everyone,
knows Krishna is the God.
No one knows he's God. Everyone thinks I'm a conditioned soul. Why is Madhya Shoda? When Madhya Shoda saw the universal
Krishna, everybody thinks that I am a conditioned soul.
No one knows anything.
In a Nitya Siddha form.
Yes.
Also. That
why are they.
They need to eat. Their body doesn't need
why
food.
Why are they meeting Krishna secretly? Why? Why is Radhika meeting Krishna secretly? Why not in public?
Increase the Parikriya Bhav, right?
But why not meet Krishna in public? Why meet him secretly? Why is she hiding and sneaking?
She's married.
Yes. But why not? Why is she hiding to... why, if she's married, why can't she meet with Krishna?
It's not United States. Sorry to say.
No, because it's against Dharma.
Correct. They're considering Dharma as important.
So why do you have to follow Dharma?
Yeah.
Why?
That is perfect.
Because if you don't follow Dharma, what will happen? You go to hell.
You're talking about hell also.
You see? Everything there is like this world.
Aprakrit.
Aprakrit means prakritabhat. You have to follow Dharma. Why?
So they
because if you don't follow Dharma, you'll go to hell. Because you're a conditioned soul.
Yes. They're also thinking like that.
Yeah. They know everything. But there are two things. Krishna's Mugdha,
Sarvagyata, Mugdhata.
And Sarvagyata. Sarvagyata means Krishna knows everything. Mugdhata means he doesn't know anything. So if you want to do bhajan and taste rust, you'll have to think Krishna doesn't know anything. But if you pray to Krishna, then you'll think that he knows everything. Otherwise, no need to pray to him. Because if you only think that Krishna's Mugdhata, if you pray to him, he cannot hear you. Because he doesn't know anything.
There are kalpa vriksha, which can provide everything. Cooked, ready food, right? Still gopis cook, Radharani goes every day and cooks. She takes out all the vegetables, cuts them, chops them, makes nice sweets, dishes for Krishna. Physically she does that, am I right?
Yes. Physically,
that is
what is physically?
physically means in her bhav, right? In actual sense, I'm saying. She's
yes.
not asking Kalpa Raksha, give me a
yes, 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 she's
her.
Doing it, yes.
She's doing
it.
That's
it.
What I mean physically.
Yes.
I have no other word.
Yes, metaphysically.
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 Whatever. Physically,
yes,
metaphysically.
Yes.
That's what I think. In actuality. You know,
with her own hands.
Own hands.
Cooking
she's
own
she's
hands.
Cooking her with own hands.
Yes.
Right? So, that shows me. Then, what is the purpose of then having Kalpa Vraksha? It's a
purpose
difficult
of
question. Kalpa? Party on that.
This is not. This is. I am laughing because.
Stupid question. Huh?
No. Because.
They think deeply, not this ordinary question. Kalpa Vraksha can provide everything and none of them needs to eat. We know that Radharani wants to do seva, she is cooking for them. She wants to increase her love for Krishna. But agreed, everything is acceptable. Then why have Kalpa Vraksha? Not necessary.
What is pick up the trees being Kalpa Vraksha? Everything is Kalpa Vraksha. Even a Vaishnava, someone who is a pure devotee in this world, is a Kalpa Vraksha. Vancha Kalpa Turubhyascha. So the trees there are not Kalpa Vraksha?
What is the need of Kalpa Vraksha? Physical Vraksha I'm talking about. Physical, metaphysical, whatever. Actual Vraksha.
Yes.
There are trees who can provide you anything.
The dust is Chintamani also. What you speak of the trees, even the dust. Everything there can give everything. Everything there can give everything. Everything can. Because they have all power. Those who are pure, they have all the power of God. Sakshat Haritva Na Samasta Shastra. Even a guru in this world, he is like God. He can do everything. So, but this is not the question. What is the need there? The trees, even though there, everything there is copper bricks, even the dust is Chintamani. But this Leela, it's called Naravat Leela. You know Naravat Leela? Like ordinary human beings.
Mm-hmm.
Because if there's no feeling of ordinary human beings, then there cannot be a high level of praying.
So miss, we are very fortunate to be on earth rather than being a Vaikunthavasi, right?
Yeah, yes, yes. We're lucky to be in the line of Rupa Goswami. This
is Maharaj has written in Gopa Kumar's history, you know?
Yes.
He comes back from Vaikuntha Dham to earth to do the bhajan because he cannot go beyond that. In Vaikuntha you cannot do bhajan, right?
Krishna prayer is called Lokit Sad Bandhuvat. The relationship is Lokit Sad Bandhuvat. Like ordinary friends in this world. Everyone feels very ordinary. Then love can be manifest. Just like this boy. If he falls over, I'll go and pick him up. Are you okay? But if I think that he's God, then how will I feel? Nothing. Because he cannot be hurt by anything.
And I cannot treat him always, because I will be always in awe and reverence.
Yes, yes. So there's no awe and reverence. So therefore the love is very strong. As soon as awe and reverence comes, when awe and reverence comes, to the same degree love
basically
goes down.
Basically to increase the prema. Everything is related to prema there, right?
Yes, yes.
When there's
an Aishwarya Gyan, you know, Krishna said, Aishwarya Gyan Ki Sabha Jabatami Sri Aishwarya Shitila Prema Nahi Mora Preet. In this world, everyone worships me with Aishwarya Gyan. But that love which is made weak by Aishwarya Bhav, it cannot please me.
But there are gynecologists and cancer specialists like us in Golok Dham, if everything is same. I'm trying
what
to
are
very crude way,
there
are
doctors, everything, yes. Yes.
If people get sick also, Krishna gets a headache. If they give all the dust from their feet.
Yes. Sometimes Krishna has a fever. Sometimes...
1 minute left is going to...
He's bitten by a snake.
Stop!
Everything.
But then Radhi Manjari, Rupa Manjari are there. They can't treat Krishna. Krishna goes and begs them at their dwar. It's described here. He goes and begs their mercy. What to talk of Radharani? He goes and begs Radharani's dasis. Kindly let me have darshan of your Swami.
Yes.
Just sit tight now, please.
Right?
Just sit tight. Just sit
because
tight.
Radhika, she won't agree to meet with him. So she's in the kunj and she's put Rupa Manjari and Rati Manjari on the door like guards. Don't let him in. So first you'll have to get past them.
There are only two Rati Manjaris and Rupa Manjaris, or there can be unlimited Rati Manjaris and Rupa Manjaris.
Only one.
If we become We are followers.
Yes.
Where we go?
Then you will be serving under the guidance.
Where? Outside the Kunja.
Maybe.
There's 0 minutes recording.
Actually, you can come. Just like in this world. Anyone comes to see Gurudev. First of all, they only see him under Pravachan. Then maybe later they get the chance to speak with him. Then later maybe they visit him in Mathura. Huh? And then maybe after some years, then they in his room, massaging him and everything like this. Huh? Like this. So just as in the same way that anyone will approach a guru, in the same way we approach Radha Krishna. First of all,
okay,
we may be far away.
No,
then we may be closer and serving very closely.
We are Dasi of Dasi of Dasi of Dasi of Shruti Manjari, Rupa Manjari. What will be our service over there? Similar to Shruti Manjari,
yes,
Rupa Manjari?
Yes, like this, similar.